السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ابن القيم said, whoever shames his brother for a sin, he will be tested with the same sin. Therefore, if you hear or see a sin from another person, say, may Allah forgive us and them. Ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, said, wallahi, I fear if I shame a woman for her pregnancy, I would end up pregnant. Don't sit and watch people and look for their faults, and do not expose them or spy on them. Instead, work on yourself and fix your faults first. Remember, you will only be asked about yourself, not others. Don't look down upon so-and-so because his son is not praying or is drinking. And don't shame so-and-so because her daughter is not wearing hijab in public. You do not know the suffering of their parents in raising them, and the effort and dedication they put in order to help guide them. Don't you know that the son of Prophet Nuh alayhi salam is in hellfire? And the father of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam is also in hellfire? So stop assuming destinies and translating intentions. Instead, focus on yourself and those whom you are responsible for. Today, you might be righteous, and tomorrow you might end up with a su' khatima or a bad ending. Remember, the hearts of humans are between the fingers of Allah. They turn like the turning of boiling water. Always make sure to ask yourself, who guided you to what you're in except Allah? So if you see what you don't like in someone, say, Alhamdulillah alladhi afana mimma abtalahum bih wa faddalana ala kathirin mimman khalaqa tafdila. Rabbi aslihhum wa thabbitna. Translation: praise be to Allah who had saved me from what he had afflicted them with, and for honoring me over many of his creations. O Allah, guide them and keep us steadfast. Or you can say, Ya mukallib al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deenik. Translation: O turner of the hearts, affirm my heart upon your religion. Abu Hanifa, may Allah have mercy on him, had an alcoholic neighbor whom he tried to advise on so many occasions until he got tired and left him. One day, the wife of the alcoholic man knocked at the door of Abu Hanifa, telling him that her husband had passed away and that she wants him to pray for his janazah, but Abu Hanifa refused. Later that day, Abu Hanifa saw the man in his dream walking between the gardens of heaven, saying, tell Abu Hanifa, Alhamdulillah, that Jannah was not in his hands. When Abu Hanifa woke up, he rushed to the wife of the deceased and asked her, how was he before his death? She said, he was the same as you knew him, except that every Friday he used to feed the orphans of the estate and wipe over their heads and cry and say, pray for your uncle. It could be the dua of one of the orphans. Abu Hanifa had a deep regret after hearing this. So, my dear sister, do not shame the people of sins or look down upon them. We all live under the cover of Allah, and if Allah was to remove that cover, we would all be exposed. Don't be proud of your plenty of salah or fasts, because you do not know who is closer to Allah. Advise and don't expose, and confront but don't hurt. Don't be arrogant and don't mock, and remember that days turn exactly as the hearts turn.